Hello and welcome to M.Retta Art Studio. This is Drawing a Macaw, Part 2. The additional colors we're going to be using today are Terracotta 186, Naples Yellow 185, Dark Cadmium Yellow 108, and Burnt Ochre 187. I'm going to be starting off using Terracotta 186 to help define the feathers at the bottom. I have went and used the manicure tool to basically emboss the paper, which means to make like a little indent that your pencil will write over the top of. Here I am using the indenting tool. They use it for manicures. You can pick up a set of 4 or 5 at Walmart. They're not real expensive. And we're going to use this to emboss the paper. So I start making lines that are in the same direction as the feathers. And I do this at the beginning, and I'll do it again in the middle and at the end as I color along. And I do smaller sections, that way I can keep track of where I have made the marks, because they're really very hard to see. Here's where I have taken the colors that we just mentioned before, the additional colors, and I have swatched these out next to the picture of the Macaw, the original picture, to see which ones in my set I want to use. It's always a good idea to have a scrap piece of paper next to you, because there's going to be colors you're going to pick out that are not going to be ones you're going to use in the drawing. And you won't know how they lay down and how they work until you mark on a separate piece of paper and go over it and blend and do what you need to do there rather than do it on your piece. You're going to pick out your shadows. You're going to pick out the ones for your midtones. And you already have the light base layer, but you're going to need maybe something that's a little lighter. I'm going to be using the terracotta pencil to do the shadowing and the shading and around and underneath where I've already embossed the feathers of the paper. So you're going to see me start working with that. I don't go in with the darkest, you know, press hard. I do like a light color over the top, just real light color, and make sure that's where I want it to be, and that I've got all the embossing done that I need to have done prior to going ahead and finishing up with the shading, because I may need to go back and make more marks. Here I'm going in with the color Naples Yellow 185, and I'm doing like a middle tone just to give it a little bit darker, richer color. By using this technique, you can save yourself hours of work and frustration trying to keep your pencils sharp enough to go and make the hair lines or feather lines or really fine lines in an animal or fur or whatever that you may be drawing. This will allow you to quickly go over with a darker color, and since it's embossed from using your base color, you emboss it where you are going to put your darker shadows, and that will leave space so that your dark colors can go in between those lines, filling in those shadows, and then making everything pop. You want to use the embossing tool, the little manicure set tool, and just like your pencil and like you would do with the lines and the flow of the hair, it's going to be really important that you keep that line going in the correct direction so that it looks realistic and it doesn't look artificial. Here I'm going in with a lighter color, the Naples Yellow 185, and filling in some of the mid-tones in the Macaw. Here I'm going in with the embossing tool, the manicure tool, and I'm making the feather lines, embossing it. And wherever I am embossing it, I know I'm going to go underneath of that with a darker color. And that's going to be the shadow area of the feather. It would be the same if you were doing it with the hair as well. And you can do this for each additional color. So if you have your light tones, your mid tones, and then your darks that you use for your shadows, you have lines that are in a fur and the feathers that are light. You can emboss those. And when you go over it with the second color, your mid tone, it won't go through or into the indent in the paper. So that hairline will show up. And then once you make the mid-tone lines and you get all of those set, then you emboss over that for the third line, and that's for your darks. Here I am using the blue color Delft Blue. It is a purplish blue, and I used that color up in the hair close to the purple feathers, purpley blue feathers, right there underneath that where the yellow is at, just to define that more and to make it really come to life. I also was using the other yellow color, the dark cadmium yellow number 108, in certain sections of the feathers. And then that light blue that you're seeing there, up into the purple feathers here, you're going to see in a minute. And that was the highlight of those feathers. They were not a white, because highlights are pure white, but it was just the light part of the purple feather. And I did find that the use of the terracotta, the 186, for shading up into the yellow and even over the blue that you're going to see here in just a few minutes really made this drawing come to life as well. So the proper use of your purples, your oranges, your opposites on the color wheel really affect how your image is going to come out and make a real big difference in the depth and the quality of your drawing, as well as whenever you take it to have a print made at a copy store anywhere. It's going to come out as a true color. It's going to pop, not be bland or look dead. So this is a good technique to use. Remember your color theory. Opposite colors on the color wheel are what you want to shade with. And also make sure they're the right colors. So if you have like a bright yellow, you don't want to use a dark purple to shade. You want to use a lighter violet with a lighter yellow so that it looks correct. And I always sample and do this on a scrap piece of paper and make sure that the colors are going to play off well. I'll practice my shading there, because sometimes you get a color that's, depending on the brand that you're using, it might be green and it just doesn't come out right because the base color and the pigment in it isn't what you thought it was. And this is especially true if you're using cheaper pencils like regular Crayola pencils, or even some of the Prismacolors have got some green undertones to it that don't come out really well. Sepia, I know, was one of the ones that was hard to use because it had the green undertones. So always practice on a separate piece of paper your color swatches or things that you want to do so that you know in advance how your colors are going to lay down and how they're going to work. So you see, we went over with the embossing tool, and now I'm going over the top of that with my mid-tone blue so I can get an idea of where the lines are showing up. And you go in really light at first to make sure that you know where those lines are at, and it gives you an idea on a visual aid. Because when you emboss, you really can't see the line. You're just kind of doing an educated guess as you go in and just going with the stroke of the fur or the feather. And as you go, you're making just those individual small lines that are going to show up. The color that I'm using here for the highlight of the feathers is the number 146. That's sky blue. And I'm going to use that for the blue in the feathers that you see as the highlight there. And then down underneath where it starts to blend into the yellow, I'm going to use it there as well. This is the terracotta color that I was talking to you guys about. And going over the top of that blue, you can see that it doesn't make it look muddy, as if you're going to use like a gray or black. You don't want to use black when you're doing your shading. You use your opposite colors. And it just makes it kind of pop, and it looks clean. And as part of, you know, the feathers and the orange and the yellows all kind of blending together, and it makes it more cohesive. This is the end of the part two tutorial. We're going to be wrapping up in the next one, episode three. And so I want to say farewell. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.